Good day, I'm Bob Tritten. I'm a district horticulturalist with Michigan State University Extension here in southeast Michigan in mid-July or so. And we're actually standing in my patch of black raspberries. And today I want to be talking about pruning and care of black or summer fruiting raspberries. And that would include black raspberries and purple raspberries and red raspberries as well. Now, there are other types of raspberries that I won't talk about today, but these are ones that typically in Michigan would be harvested about now, starting in early July and running through the third or fourth week of July. And a couple of horticultural points that I think are going to be important for anybody who grows summer-bearing raspberries in their backyard is the fact that there are two different ages of canes in this planting. And I have my planting trellised with wires down either side. That's so I can have my rows a little bit closer together. And a little bit later, we'll show you what those rows could look like. There are always new canes in a patch of raspberries, summer-bearing raspberries. And these new canes are called primacanes, or I like to call them vegetative canes, or first-year canes. And these canes, you'll notice that the leaves are really large and nice and green, and the cane itself is a nice green color. And then there's another set of canes that are in this raspberry patch that are second year canes that are horticulturally called flora canes. And these flora canes are fruiting canes, or what I call second year canes. And so the cane grows 1 year, and there's going to be some pruning that we're going to be doing on that cane the first year, and then the second year that same cane will have some fruit on. And what I'm trying to establish is a nice short bushy cane that has lots of berries about chest high or so, not so long that they get gangly and don't fruit very well, but short enough and compact enough that they can have a lot of high quality fruit that is available for harvest. So let me start with the pruning and we do all this pruning about now in the summertime on new canes as they're beginning to grow. When the cane gets to be about 5 or 6 feet tall, I simply tip the cane just above a leaf. And what do I do with these prunings? These prunings I put into either a community recycling program, if you have curbside recycling, or else put them into a burn pile. Generally, I don't throw these canes into a compost pile because they don't seem to compost very well. And so, for my purposes, I have a community recycling program, and so I'll simply put them into a bag and put them out to the curb. Now, what's going to happen on this particular cane over the next 3 or 4 weeks is we're going to get a number of side branches that grow right here. And once those side branches grow out to be about 15 inches or so in length, we're going to do some tipping on those side branches as well, and that's going to create a nice, short, stout cane. So this is the cane, the pruning that we do on a first year or primacane. Let me show you what that cane is going to look like next year. And I'm actually going to kind of burrow down in here and pull out a cane that has some fruit on left. But just for the purposes of illustration, I think we'll show what it is that we're trying to create. So right here we have a beautiful 2-year-old cane. I think you can see some fruit that has been harvested over the last couple weeks. This cane is just about done. Now, it's really easy to tell the difference between new canes and old canes. The primacanes, the color of the cane itself is a green color, whereas on the older 2-year canes, it's woody and some of the bark has already begun to peel off. So when in these summer red raspberries, this is really what I'm trying to create, a nice short stout cane. And here I think you can see pretty well that last year about this time I tipped the cane right here. And then a number of these side branches grew, and then generally I cut those off at about 12 or 15 inches in length to create this right here. Now, this year, the other pruning I'm going to be doing on these red raspberries or black raspberries is to take out these fruited canes. Now, I'm not quite ready to do that yet because I still have a few more berries to harvest, but in a few weeks here, once these berries are harvested, I'm simply going to reach down right at the ground and pick those canes out or cut those canes out as low to the ground as I can. You might see that there are some diseases on this cane, and by pruning out these summer black and red raspberries during the summertime, it eliminates this disease and can keep these new canes nice and healthy for you for your crop next year. So I'm just going to work away here at cutting back some of these new canes about the chest height again or so, and review the process of pruning summer raspberries in the backyard. Again, we have two different types of canes, new canes and old canes. The new canes need to be tipped at about chest height or so in early July. The canes are then going to grow some side branches, and then we're going to tip those again here rather shortly in about 3 or 4 weeks. Once we've completed harvest of our summer raspberries, that's the point in time that we take the whole cane out. And I showed you what that looked like just a minute ago. And that's simply a case of dropping down and pruning those as low to the ground as you can possibly reach. So those are the steps that are involved in pruning summer raspberries. They're a beautiful crop to grow, very tasty for table use and for making jams and jellies, and also putting some in the freezer. And if you're lucky enough, maybe to have a pie or two.